Hi there, this is Fei Wu from Feisworld Media, and in this video I want to show you and give you a walkthrough of how I use Headliner to create these wonderful audiograms for my podcast. So first, when you land on this page, make.headliner.app, I believe there is a free version. For the free version, what you're giving up is that you will see the Headliner logo. But to be honest, if you're just testing things out, you really don't have to go all the way up to Pro just yet. As you can see, this is the version I'm using. Other than the watermark of Headliner, I don't see other issues really. So when you get started, there are several options to choose from. And you have Audio Wizard, Full Episode, Video Transcript, Podcast, Auto Videos. And this is pretty cool. So oftentimes I find myself using audiograms because it's turning in shorter audio clips into short videos with a waveform you can easily share on social media. Whereas these full episodes are turning up to 2 hours of your audios into videos. I haven't really tried this one out as much because I find it hard for people to really watch a audiogram for 2 hours. So let's get started the traditional way. Audio Wizard. When you get here, you have the options to basically drag and drop your audio files here, either MP3 or WAV file. So I'm going to go ahead and go to my podcast and grab a short episode. Okay, so I'm going to do a mini episode of freelancing. How to be a freelance PM, for example. This is not a super short episode. It's about 30 minutes long, but I'm only going to use the one from the kind of the beginning. So please select the language, audio transcription. So there you go. And you can choose different languages here. I'm going to stick with English, United States. So there you go. And click on next. So now you can select 10 minutes or less of an audio. As you can see, more than 10 minutes, you are then forced to go to the full episode option. I'm going to click. So that's just my intro at the very beginning. Obviously, that's not very interesting. So if you know your clip start and end point, so if you listen to your audio and be able to make that decision very quickly, that's a really good way to go about it too. So I was able to listen to the audio and I have selected a clip that starts right around 41 to 42 seconds and it ends around 1 minute and 12 seconds in. So it's easier, I think, for me to edit it this way. So just for me to kind of type in the clip start and end. And from there, what I can do is click on next. So the duration, as you can see, is roughly 30 seconds. Now I can choose the aspect ratio. Obviously, when you choose landscape, it's best for YouTube and websites. When you choose a square, it's best for social media, including Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. That's what we're going to stick with. And of course, portrait. That's, I was going to say Pinterest, but now, as you can see, also Instagram, Snapchat, and TikTok. So now I select a square, I can go into the next phase, which is customize your audiogram. You have several things you can kind of change, you know, wave, bars, things like that. Just for fun, I'm going to choose this. And you can also change the color. If you have a brand color, you can easily put in the hex number, the RGB, that sort of thing. You can choose the position of where you want this to be, but you can also easily drag and drop kind of where this needs to be. Now, wave generation, I prefer fast. And then any text you can add to this as well. And last but not least is the image. Typically, what I enjoy using is Canva, but in this case, this is something I have already designed. So I'm going to go to my freelance resource page and click on this artwork right here, project manager, freelance project manager, and it's already done. I'm just going to save that. Now I'll come back to Headliner and drop in this image. Okay, that looks good. So now with the image in, you can more easily see what's going on and what you want to hide. So I'm going to put it at the very bottom here. Looks like fire. In fact, that I might choose something. Ooh, this green is kind of exciting. Just for laughs, what you want to do is pick something that's more visible. It doesn't have to be overly exaggerated, but you don't want to use a very fainted color like black or gray that overlaps with the image behind it. So progress animation, we're not going to be bothered about that. So let's take a look at create project. This may take a few minutes, usually sooner than that, but I'm going to pause the recording so you don't have to sit here and wait. All right, it took just about 30 to 40 seconds, I would say. And there you have it. And you can also see that there are transcriptions or closed captions right here. You can click on it and see.
This is Feiwu, and
you're listening to another episode of How to Freelance. Okay, great. See, you can actually go in here and able to change certain things. I'm actually pleased that I finally learned my name. But as you can see, you can go in and kind of play this whole thing. That's why I recommend these, you know, shorter clips, because it is time consuming and labor intensive if you have to edit everything. But let's say that everything looks good, checked out. You can just export the whole thing. You're good to go.
And today I want to talk about,
you see, this is, so this green waveform is kind of floating, jumping back and forth. And here you still have the opportunity to edit the media file. If you don't like this one, you can change it into another one. Lastly, style, background color, things that we talked about, or any watermark you want to add to this, you can do so right now. So that's it. So I'm going to click on export. In the export option, the good news is, you know, you can enter your email address, you'll be notified. I would leave everything as they are. Video quality is high, you know, it's short enough. If you have a really long video, you can switch it down to medium if you want. Intro clips, we don't have intro or outro. Let's just go ahead and export that. Now it says your video will be ready soon, and next time you can save time by videos directly from your podcast host. Request a headliner integration. Okay, so if you are using Libsyn, I recently noticed that Libsyn actually integrated with their platform, and I just moved my podcast over to Anchor. I do not see an integration. However, as you can see, it's easy enough to log into Headliner and be able to do it right here. Your video is ready. You can download it here. You click on the download button and you're presented with this easy to share URL. You can upload to cloud storage if you want to save a copy of these things, which we do, by the way. And we organize that in our Google Drive. You could download it. You could share it on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram right away. So hope you find this helpful. Please let me know how you're able to use audiograms. We as Feisworld Podcast has seen a tremendous amount of growth using audiograms. They're really fun. They're very eye-catchy. Also, it gives you the opportunity to really introduce your podcast to a whole new audience or a new episode. If you interview someone who isn't as known in social media or isn't like a thought leader, a KOL, then you can really use this teaser to introduce that person's voice and point of view to your new listeners. We in particular have seen a tremendous growth on Pinterest. Audiograms as these shorter video clips are just driving a lot of impressions and engagement. Hope you find this helpful. Again, this is Faye from Feisworld Media. This channel is all about helping freelancers and creative entrepreneurs live their financial and creative freedom. I'm so glad you're here. Please hit subscribe and hit the bell button, and I'll see you in the next video.